Hello, Copperheads! My name is Cupri. Welcome to the channel. Wilson's disease is a rare genetic condition of copper metabolism. Are you a patient of Wilson's disease? Are you a loved one of someone who has Wilson's disease? Are you a doctor? Are you a future doctor? Are you just someone spiraling out of control on YouTube at 3 in the morning? Then this is the channel for you. Okay, but seriously, you're probably here because you're a patient yourself. Wilson's disease is quite rare and quite complicated, so chances are you're quite confused. Unless you have quite advanced knowledge of human biology, which most people don't have. But don't worry, I'm here to help. You see, I love biology, and I love education, and I love even more helping people. So what better thing to do with my free time than to help people by educating them about the biology of Wilson's disease? Before we begin, you must know, I am not a doctor. However, I do have 2 bachelor degrees in biology.
Plant biology.
I graduated magna cum laude with distinction in research from an Ivy League university in the US.
I'm poor but smart. I was there on a full scholarship.
The point is, I know how to find good scientific information, how to understand it, and how to explain it. I have been studying everything there is to know about Wilson's disease since July 2016, when I first learned I might have it. Due to a number of medical situations, I actually still don't know if I have it or if I'm just a carrier. Actually, as of right now, February 2018, I have been stuck in diagnostic limbo for 19 months. Throughout this time, I have learned that most doctors don't really know much about Wilson's disease. And I have spent a lot of time in online patient communities doing my best to help patients and their loved ones understand more about Wilson's disease. And I have also learned a lot from many people in these groups. There are 4 reasons why I've decided to start a YouTube channel. 1. Certain common questions come up over and over again. 2. Some things are very difficult to explain just in writing. 3. Many people learn better by watching and listening than by reading. And 4. There just aren't any free, updated, comprehensive resources that explain Wilson's disease in terms most people can understand. In this video, I will be making a quick summary of Wilson's disease. And in future videos, I will be going deep into different topics. For example, the first topic we're gonna cover after this video is gonna be the genetics of Wilson's disease. It doesn't matter if you don't really know what DNA is or you don't understand what recessive means. That's what I'm here for. That's what my mission is all about, helping as many people as possible understand the details of Wilson's disease. So here's the plan. 1. Every Wednesday I will post a video on YouTube. Get it? Wednesday, WD. Wilson's disease, ha ha. Number 2, every Sunday I will post a drawing or illustration on Instagram. And number 3, all other days of the week I will post memes or links to interesting resources from all over the internet. So go right now and search for Wilson's disease Copperheads on social media and like, follow, subscribe to keep learning more about Wilson's disease. Okay, so after that whole introduction, let's get to the point. Wilson's disease. What is that? Wilson's disease is a genetic disorder of copper metabolism. Copper is a reddish, orangish metal. You've seen it, for example, most cables have copper inside. But copper is also an essential micronutrient for humans. In other words, a nutrient we need, but only in small amounts. The average person gets too much copper from the diet. When we're talking about a healthy person without Wilson's disease, it doesn't really matter that they eat too much copper because the human body has a system to keep the right amount of copper and get rid of the rest. So, this is what happens if you have a healthy copper metabolism. You eat food, it goes down to your stomach, then to the intestines. Copper gets absorbed from the food in the stomach and the intestines, and it gets sent to the liver. The portion of copper that you need goes to the bloodstream, and then to the rest of the body. And the portion of copper you don't need goes to the bile, which goes to the poop, which goes to the toilet. But what happens when you have Wilson's disease? Well, the first part is just the same. You eat food, the copper gets absorbed and sent to the liver, But then it gets stuck in the liver. It cannot leave from there in the usual way. So over time, copper builds up. It accumulates in the liver. And all that excess copper hanging around in there eventually causes tissue damage. The damaged liver tissue breaks, releases a bunch of copper into your bloodstream, and then the copper ends up accumulating in other parts of your body, especially your brain, but also your eyes, kidneys, pancreas, heart, parathyroid glands, joints, etc. And then it creates all sorts of symptoms and problems. The symptoms of Wilson's disease are so diverse that I will make several videos just about this topic. So, back in the day when we didn't have treatment for Wilson's disease, it was 100% fatal. Literally everyone who had it died from it. Unless, you know, they died from something else, like they got run over by a bus. Thankfully, nowadays we have effective treatment options. Some of the problems caused by Wilson's disease in your body can be reversed with treatment, and some of them cannot. So it's very, very, very important to diagnose Wilson's disease as soon as possible, because it's better to prevent damage before it happens than to try to fix it afterwards. So how is Wilson's disease diagnosed? Well, it can be a combination of blood tests, urine tests, eye examinations, liver biopsy, brain MRI, and genetic tests. I will be making some very detailed videos about this, because from what I've seen, most people are not familiar with all the rules and exceptions to the rules that are involved in diagnosing Wilson's disease. And then, what happens if you get diagnosed with Wilson's disease? Well, you're relatively lucky because there is effective treatment, which is not true of many other genetic diseases out there, so yay! The treatment is a bit different for everyone. It should depend mostly on your symptoms. But, sadly, sometimes it also depends on where you live and how much money you have, because we live in a world with huge, huge healthcare inequalities. Again, this is a topic I will address in detail in future videos, but I'm gonna give you a brief overview of the different treatment options that are available. Some of them can be combined, some of them cannot. It's gonna depend on each case. Number one, chelation medication. Chelators are like cleaning trucks. They pick up the excess copper that has been deposited around your body and then they get eliminated in the urine when you pee. Number two, zinc. When you take zinc with food, it blocks your body from absorbing the copper in the food. Number three, low copper diet. If you eat less copper, you have less copper to deal with. Number four, liver transplant. This is only for people whose livers are very, very damaged, because it's a very risky operation, and also because there are lots of people out there who need new livers for many reasons, and there just aren't enough donated livers for everybody. When someone with Wilson's disease gets a liver transplant, their new liver is able to deal with copper in a healthy way, so they don't need to take medication for Wilson's disease anymore. But they do need to take anti-rejection medication for the rest of their lives. And finally, number five, there are a number of new treatments being developed or tested as we speak. So it's very possible that soon we will have more options available to the public. Alright, Copperheads, this has been my introduction to the channel and to Wilson's disease. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week when we talk about the genetics of Wilson's disease. Did you like this video? Did you learn something new? What do you want to know about Wilson's disease? Please tell me, leave me a comment. But first, make sure to read the Copperhead community rules in the video description box or on the pinned post on Facebook. You can also send me a private message on any of the Wilson's disease Copperhead social media profiles or by email. And I will personally respond to all comments and messages I get from you all. Subscribe on YouTube, follow on Instagram, like on Facebook, or send me an email. My name is Cupri. See you there, Copperheads!